Hey, this is Deepak here, broadcasting live from Salem, Tamil Nadu. And this is the first time I'm doing YouTube live. I usually do live webinars for my community and for my email list. But this time I thought, hey, maybe I should try YouTube live because there are quite a lot of subscribers on my YouTube channel. And I decided to just, you know, talk about random topic and, you know, start talking about, you know, things which I learn and experience for the benefit of everyone. If you like it, you can watch it. Not every video will be about digital marketing. And so today I wanted to talk about 36-hour fasting and is it good for your health? So I recently started you know, testing for my blood sugar levels, right? And there is a test called HbA1c. And HbA1c is a test which does not measure your fasting blood glucose, like because fasting blood glucose is usually the amount of sugar that you have in your blood at any point in time. So you try to do it in the early morning, it'll just measure what is the sugar level in your blood. But you can do non-fasting blood sugar level test as well, but the problem is that it varies, it goes up and down. So there is this test called HbA1c, which is probably a little bit costlier, and most of the labs can test for HbA1c. So the HbA1c is basically the amount of bonding that the sugar molecules does with the hemoglobin molecules, or that's the way I understand it. So what it does is that it gives you a measurement, which is the average of the blood sugar that you have for the past 3 months. So that gives you a more accurate measurement. So 5.6 or below is normal. 5.6 to 6.4 is pre-diabetes, and more than 6.4 is diabetes. So my reading was just at 5.6. So it did not go into the danger level, but it was 5.6, which got me a little bit concerned, because nowadays we eat a lot of foods, and these types of foods usually are like very sugary. You know, you order something online, order from Swiggy, Zomato, you order ice creams, you eat chocolates. So all these things end up releasing a lot of sugar inside your bloodstream very fast. And that causes diabetes, and a lot of my friends in my age group, 30 to 35 age group, already are pre-diabetic. So this started, becoming a little bit of a concern for me, because I definitely wanted to, make some lifestyle changes to my health habits and eating habits, so that it does not go about 5.6, and that can kind of create quite a lot of problems, right? So I started reading a book called The Diabetes Code. And this book basically talked about the benefits of fasting, especially 36-hour fast. So a lot of people do fasting for religious benefits and all those different types of things that they do, mostly spiritual and religious things. But fasting is something that has been there for quite a long time, probably thousands and thousands of years, as long as humans existed, probably millions of years, because when humans discovered agriculture 12,000 years back, that's when they started having consistent supply of food. You know, before that, they were, just hunter-gatherers and foragers, and they used to go to different places. And in these different places, they used to, get berries, fruits, and things like that. I think sometimes they hunted for food, but many times they didn't get food. So the body is designed in such a way that when you get food, it stores it up. And when you don't have food, it burns the energy. That is how the body is designed. But 12,000 years back is when humans discovered agriculture. And since then, obviously, it has created a lot of problems for the humankind, for which you should read the book called Sapiens. But keeping that aside, not really getting into the whole story of the human evolution, basically what happens is that today in this world, more people die of obesity than people who are dying of starvation. So what happens is that, you know, when you keep eating foods and not even sugary foods or chocolates or, you know, ice creams, even if you eat carbohydrates, like let's say you have, you know, white rice, very, very harmful to the health, because what happens is that as soon as you eat the white rice, it is easily digestible. It is polished rice. And because it is easily digestible, the release of glucose in the bloodstream is instant. And as soon as the glucose is released in the bloodstream, the glucose cannot enter your cells, which is all over your body, including your heart, including your, you know, essential organs and everything. So what happens is that as soon as the glucose is released in the blood sugar level spikes up, but it cannot enter the cells. And to enter the cells, you need insulin. So your pancreas makes insulin, and insulin is basically the key to open up the door of the cells so that the sugar can be absorbed into the cells. And there is an instant spike of insulin. So as soon as there is an instant spike of insulin, what happens is that sometimes the insulin is secreted more than that is required for the body, because the body cannot allow sugar to stay in your blood for a very long time, because it also affects the you know, carrying of oxygen from your lungs to all your organs and cells. So the sugar has to be absorbed by the cells immediately. So the insulin secretion is a little bit more than expected. And because of this, there is something called insulin resistance that happens in your body. So what is insulin resistance? So let's say you go for a nightclub and you are going for a party, and in the nightclub, the music is really loud. So your ears become a little bit less sensitive to sound, right? If somebody is whispering to you, you can't really hear them, because of so much sound, the sensitivity of the, you know, ear is reduced. So similarly, what happens is that imagine insulin is the noise and your cells are like your ears. What happens is that because of there is so much insulin that is produced, the cells kind of become a little bit insensitive to insulin. So if this happens for years and then you eat something high carb and high sugar, what happens is that you end up having a lot of insulin resistance on your cells. So what happens is that the insulin is secreted in the pancreas and the cells are not really responding well. So this is when the sugar is not going into the cells properly. And because the sugar is not going into the cells properly, the sugar stays in the blood more. And this happens gradually over a period of years. That's when the blood sugar level increases. And when the blood sugar level increases, your blood cannot go ahead and carry the oxygen properly into your vital organs. And that's when people start becoming sick. That's when they develop type 2 diabetes. So when people go to the doctor saying that, hey, I have type 2 diabetes, the doctors don't say, hey, go do fasting. Instead, what they say is that take this tablet. So they give a tablet called metformin. And this particular tablet called metformin kind of increases the absorption of sugar into the cells. So imagine like you have a lot of garbage in your house and the garbage man is not collecting the garbage. So you end up stuffing the garbage under your bed. It's as stupid as that to have metformin and get the cells to absorb the blood sugar faster and more efficiently, because insulin is not doing its job. It cannot do its job because the cells have developed a lot of insulin resistance. So what happens is that people start gaining weight. They start becoming fat. When they have type 2 diabetes and when they take metformin, they are not just reducing the intake of food. So imagine that you are, the previous example, you went to a nightclub and you had a very heavy sound on your ears. Your ears become a little bit insensitive to sound and you cannot hear properly. And imagine people who are in very noisy places, like let's say somebody has a shop just next to a very you know, high traffic road, and he would eventually not have enough hearing capacity over time because he is constantly being bombarded with loud noises. So imagine you went to a nightclub and next day you went ahead and just spent time in silence. Do you think your hearing sensitivity will improve? Obviously, yes, because now you are spending time in silence. your brain will start adjusting for it. Your ear will start adjusting for it. So similarly, when you do fasting, especially when you do 36-hour fasting, which is like, for example, I am fasting right now. So my last meal was yesterday night, and my next meal is going to be tomorrow morning. So you are basically giving rest to your entire system. It is recommended that you do not, you know, spend too much energy during these times. Basically, it is recommended to chill out, probably watch TV, and drink plenty of water. So what happens is that you are first of all giving good rest to your intestine and your pancreas. And when you do not eat food, there is no glycogen or glucose released in the bloodstream. And anyway, I'm not a medical expert. So if you have any problems, definitely consult a healthcare professional. This is just my opinion, suggestion, and disclaimer for entertainment purposes only. So anyway, back to the topic. So what happens is that you are not releasing any blood sugar, any sugar into the blood. And because of that, your cells are taking rest, your pancreas is taking rest. And since your cells are not getting any insulin, your cells' insulin sensitivity increases. So increasing the insulin sensitivity and reducing the calorific intake can naturally reverse type 2 diabetes. And unfortunately, most of the people don't read books, they don't do research, they just go to a doctor. And the whole of medical community, I don't know why they do not recommend fasting as a cure. Fasting is a cure for a lot of diseases, and there is nothing wrong with fasting because humans have always had inconsistent food supply throughout history. And even if you fast for 2-3 days and drink plenty of water, nothing is going to happen. And when I say fasting, zero calorific intake, no sugar, nothing, no fruits, no juices, no tea, no coffee, just water for 36 hours. And it kind of changes your mood also, because now that you are giving rest, usually your sugar is what gives you a lot of dopamine in your head. So you are also dopamine fasting during this time. And it increases your mood, gives you better sleep. And then you can break your fast the next day morning. So tomorrow morning, I will be breaking my fast. And when you are breaking the fast, it is recommended that you take foods which are not too easily digestible, like do not eat idli or dosa or rice type of food, basically, or bread for that matter, right? So you go ahead and take some food like a smoothie or a, shake, which is like, flax seeds or, something of that sort, which is not easily digestible. And then you slowly break the fast towards the afternoon. And this kind of makes your whole system reset, makes your, hormonal systems reset. And definitely reduces fat and keeps you lean. And I have noticed that since I have started fasting, so I try to fast at least once in a week. I have not been too consistent at that. But whenever I do, 2 to 3 weeks of consistent fasting, where I do fasting for, once every week, and if I do it for 2-3 weeks, my belly just, collapses, right? Because all the fat gets burned, and you will be reducing your intake of, your total intake of, calories for the week by almost 15%. So instead of cutting down on food for each and every meal, which is called chronic calorific restriction, which is not really healthy, it is better to eat well, eat healthy, eat without guilt, and do fasting once in a week, 36-hour fast. So I will probably try 36 plus 24-hour fast, which is how much? So that is 36 plus 24. So a 60-hour fast is something that I will be trying next time. But this time, it's just a 36-hour fast, and I will probably be doing more of it. And so that's the live stream for today, the very first live stream that I have done for my YouTube channel. And I will probably do more of this, probably go cross topics. And I know that my video setup is not that great. My lighting setup is not that great. I will definitely improve this setup. Stay tuned for it. But I need a good response for this live stream. So if you guys like the information, let me know in the chat box. And if you are not watching this live, and if you are watching a recorded version, I would like to get your comments if you want more videos like this, because I read a lot of books apart from digital marketing and marketing and business. I read about relationships, read about negotiation, read about history, politics, health, fitness, spirituality. I read, you know, pretty much all kinds of books that is out there. And I thought it would be great to share that information on live streams like this from time to time, so that I also have a motivation to read the book. And since a lot of people do not have a lot of time to read books, maybe you guys can learn from these live streams. So I have a question in the live stream. 36 plus 24, two times a week? No, 36 plus 24 hours, one time a week. Even the 36 hours fast is one time a week, but yeah, 36 plus 24 is going to be at a stretch, which means that if you had eaten yesterday night, don't eat for the whole day. And if you eat tomorrow morning, then it's a 36 hour fast. If you eat day after tomorrow morning, then it's a 60 hour fast. So that's about it. And hope you liked it. And I will see you in the next live stream on my YouTube channel. And bye-bye.